to all my goddesses and my sisters and my universal brothers. It's very windy out here, so I'm hoping that the camcorder videotape thingy doesn't just fall over, because it's gorgeous out here. I'm all packed. Yeah, I'm all packed. I'm excited. I am excited. I'm very excited. I'm happy. I'm excited and I'm sad. And part of this journey is embracing how you feel in the now. And I don't know why that we've all, I'm using we all generally, you know, because some of us may have had different training, but we've been taught not to feel. We've been taught, what's today's date, by the way? I should do that, right? Today, it's exactly 4 o'clock on Sunday, April 13th. And I'll be going to my youngest daughter's house either tomorrow or Tuesday. And I'll be there until May 22nd when I take my plane and I fly. And I'm off to discover my joy. And I think that's the thing. Like, I'm so excited about it. Of course I am. I'm totally excited. This is the first time in my life that I'm doing something just because I want to do it and not because I'm a mom or because I'm a daughter or a wife or just because I'm me, just because I'm Shanti. And I'm very, very excited. There's a string that is flying around and I'm like, oh, for real? Okay, wait. How do we do that? I don't know. That's how we do that. That's how we do that, because now it's gone. All right, so I'm very excited. I have grown children. They're 26, 25, and 24. And yet there's a piece of me that's like, you're leaving them? The world will end tomorrow, you're leaving them? But if the world will end tomorrow, it gotta be me. And I've never done this before. Never done anything just because I'm called to do it. I've done it for every other reason. For security. I did it for security, for stability. I've done it for every other reason except just because I wanted to. I want to do this. I want to talk to young women. I want to talk to them. I want to say to them, damn it, I see you. I see you. I know what fear feels like. I know what the feeling is to want to do something so badly and be so frightened of the what ifs and the maybe that will happen and maybe that won't happen and maybe they want me and maybe they don't, and oh my goodness, it could drive you insane. So this is what I'm doing. I don't know. I don't even know how I got to this point where I'm all packed and I'm ready to go, because on this journey just to becoming packed, I was like, I looked around at everything and I was like, that's a lot. Am I going to be able to do that? Am I going to be able to do that? Do I want to do that? Yeah, I want to do that. Can I do it? And I stopped looking at the future. And I kept bringing myself back into the now, right here, right now. That's all I got, and that's all I can handle, truly. So I'm sitting here with a song that I'm going to play. Yeah, I'm a little better, better what? Because I can't even speak. I had the song picked out for real, where to go. You see? Okay, I do.
It's been a while.
I'm not who I was before. It's the truth.
You look surprised. Your words don't burn me anymore.
It doesn't.
Been meaning to tell you, but I guess it's clear to see. Don't be mad. It's just a brand new kind of me. Can't be bad. I found a brand new kind of free.
Found a brand new kind of free.
Careful with your ego, he's the one that we should play. Had to grab my heart back, God knows something had to change.
something had to change.
Thought that you'd be happy. I found the one thing I need. Why you mad? It's just a brand new kind of me. It took a long, long time to get here.
It did take a long time to get here. And it took a brave, brave girl to try. And it takes a brave girl now. Because I realized today as I was talking to people in my house that a lot of the animosity and the anger and the, you know, attitudes that I've been getting lately is some people just don't know how to say, I'm sorry, I'm gonna miss you. And that's okay. It's a process for all my Canadian family. It's a process. I don't know if I could do that. But yeah, this is where I'm at. I'm in this moment, and I'm happy, sad. I'm happy, sad. Sad and happy. And it's okay. I followed my intuition this winter, and I had lost the desire to cook. And that's very unusual for me because I love to create in the kitchen, and I didn't want to cook, and I thought, I chalked it up to me being lazy. I was like, Shanti, you gotta love yourself, you gotta cook. And I was just like, I'm not drawn to do that here. Maybe it just didn't feel like home to me. I didn't want to do it. And I found out yesterday that it was a great thing that I didn't cook because there's something wrong with the water here. And I've already been experiencing the detrimental effects of the water, and had I done all the cooking that I thought I should do and normally would have done, I would have definitely had more toxins inside my body. And with having fibromyalgia, scoliosis, sciatica, and osteoarthritis, I don't claim any of that. They say I have that. I think I'm perfectly healed, healthy, and on fire. But had I consumed all that water and all that concentrated toxicity, had I consumed all of that, I might have been worse for wear. So I'm so grateful that I followed my intuition and avoided, I don't know how bad it could have been, because I know that even with the limited amounts of water that I did get into my system, there were I'm trying to have a quiet video, I really am, but this is what it is. This is real. I'm not retaping this. I have water flying over there. I have leaves flying. It's warm enough to be out here in a t-shirt, but it's kind of cool. Anyway, the point is that I narrowly escaped a lot of toxins in my body, and I don't even know how many got in there. I'm going to try to get a sample of the water and see what's going on. But I think it's miraculous that I'm learning to listen to my intuition instead of beating myself up about the choices that I think I should be making according to the training that I've had. So that being said, when you're in the midst of choices and decisions, and you have this little core feeling and it's saying don't do it, and everything in you screaming, do it, you should, you have to, that's self-love, yeah, no, follow it, just go with your feeling. That's what I'm doing. I'm learning to use my intuition, and listen to myself. I've never realized just how noisy it is around here before, and this is low. Yeah. Oh, it's a child doll. That's cool. So this is where I'm at, and this is gonna definitely, truly be my last vlog in Taunton, since I'm leaving tomorrow, Tuesday morning. I'm going to dinner tonight with my sister, technically my ex-sister-in-law, but no, that's my sister. I'm going to dinner tonight with my sister Tiffany and my niece Ariana to have a little goodbye dinner. And then I'm going to come home and just probably like make sure I got everything. When I get to my daughter's house, I'll do more of an OCD kind of packing, because I need to have everything exactly where I need it. And my box is on its way to Texas and should be there Tuesday. And Tuesday is 1 week from Naira, my granddaughter being born, and my cousin is coming from New York with my little cousin and her boyfriend, and we're gonna have a magnificent few days of reunion and yay and all that good stuff. And then 1 week from then, 6 days from there, my parents are coming, 7 days from there, Naira's born, and exactly one month from Naira's birth, I'll be on a plane to Texas. I'm following my joy. Yes, it feels a little different. No, it feels a lot of different. But I gotta do this. I gotta follow my joy. I'm 46. I wanna know. I wanna go ziplining. I wanna go. Is that a universal nod? Ziplining, yes? Yes? Okay. I wanna go ziplining. I wanna hike. I wanna dance underneath the moon with my sisters. I wanna embrace. Now it's cold. I want to embrace my bohemian spirit. I want to fly. I want to know what this, I feel the current. I feel the current of source running through my veins, and I just can't go back. I can't go back to playing it small. I can't do it. I can do it. I don't choose to do it. I don't want that anymore. I have to see what else there is. And so that's it for today. I don't know how long I've taken. Let me see if this is still playing. So I don't know what's playing. So I know for sure that I'm definitely not as peppy as I was the other day, because well, we're down in the crunch now. We're down in the crunch. And it's, I'm ready, I'm on the runway for takeoff, and it's a beautiful, beautiful experience, and I'm highly grateful, and I'm also in the moment, so I'm feeling what I'm feeling, and I'm not making any excuses about it, and I'm not trying to numb it. I'm feeling it, and I'm good with that. To be human is to feel the gamut of emotions that come with it, the gamut of feelings that come with it. Watch them and let them go by and keep doing what you're doing. I mean, one step at a time. How do I do it? One step at a time. It takes, yeah, bravery is feeling fear and doing it anyway. The name of the song that's playing is Limitedless by Alicia Keys. To infinity. To a limitless love. Music really does it for me. I mean, music's gotten me through everything. So, okay. So, I love myself. I love you. I love my children. I love my grandchildren. I'm doing this to show them that there's no such word as can't. And I know that I probably used that in this vlog, but not as a can't, but as a can't. You get it, right? I know you get it. I know you understand it. And I'm freezing my ass off. So I'm going to go in the house and I'm going to upload this. And I'm really here in my present. I'm doing it. I'm packed. All right, I got this. I got me courage. I got me courage under my arm. Me gun fart for the joy of living, the joy of life, the succulence. I'm biting into that juicy, juicy nectar. And even that, I'm sure, has a pit in the middle. It's life, but it's all good. So on that note, loving me, loving you. I'm not editing because, honestly, I probably don't know how yet. It takes too much time, and I'm cold. So, loving me, loving you, deuces. I'm out.